Hello and good evening. I'm Cheryl D'Souza and you're watching Goa 365. Our headlines are: the task force aims to rid vector-borne diseases from the state. Student cell of Goa Pradesh Youth Congress demands immediate action against the chairman of the Students' Council. We also have Goa This Week. Those were our headlines. Now for the news in detail. With the intention of bringing down the cases of vector-borne diseases in Goa, the Director of Health Services, Dr. Rajananda Desai, said that the Health Department has worked out a proposal to eliminate malaria from the state with the help of the Indian Council of Medical Research and the World Bank.
We are tying up with the MRC Center also, and then we are observing the treatment protocol. There are research studies also going on. And then shortly we are proposing to make a proposal for the elimination of malaria from the state of Goa. And Goa will be the first state to take up this proposal. We are working on it.
Briefing media persons after the meeting of task force, Dr. Desai explained the definition of what they meant by elimination of malaria from Goa.
See, the definition of what I am saying is elimination of malaria is only there should not be a transmission amongst the locals. Means if the migrant labor who is already suffering from malaria or having the malarial parasite, he will definitely suffer from malaria, but it will not affect the local population.
She said that the health department, with the help of municipalities and panchayat, would conduct joint inspection near construction sites to control spread of malaria.
Municipality officers, then panchayat officers, and we are taking joint ventures, joint inspections. And they have realized that it is their responsibility also. And we are working jointly. So on that front also, we can say we are successful.
Health Secretary Anand Prakash said that they have asked the concerned departments to gear up mostly in Panjim, Kandolim and Kalangut in North Goa, and in South, Margao and Benauli to control spread of malaria.
So we had a meeting with all the health officers as well as all related departments, and we have requested all departments to cooperate with the health department. So the main incidence is with the, what do you call this, migrant laborers, the ones who are involved in the construction sites. And the problem is basically spread in 2-3 locations. One is Panjim, one is Kandolim, and Kalangut. These three are the hardbread, and because a lot of construction activity is going on. And fourth is near Margao, that place, Benolim. Margao as well as Benolim and all that, where maximum construction is taking place.
He said that they have approached IMA, private practitioners and NGOs for their contribution in controlling vector-borne disease.
The IMA people, to their rep was here, and he has ensured that even the private practitioners are going to treat this in a war footing. Also, a representative of the NGOs was here, and they have also asked what they can do. So we are tackling it in a sort of a uniform fashion.
The chairman of the student cell of the Goa Pradesh Youth Congress, Sunil Kautankar, sought immediate action from the Goa University against the chairman of the Students' Council, Siddesh Ramdas Naik, for misappropriation of funds during the intercollegiate event.
Briefing media persons, Mr. Kautankar said that the matter came to light when the other members went to the university to clear their bills and found out that there were no funds in the account.
People go over there. He is Amir Jamadar. He was also involved. He went with his expenditure bills to the university. University tells him that there is no fund in the account. So he goes on further to investigate why there is no fund when there was so much of sponsorship collected.
He said on the complaints received from the executive members of the Students' Council against Naik, he appointed Amit Sadadekar to conduct an inquiry which proved him guilty.
Amit Sadadekar conducted an internal inquiry into the entire episode of this misappropriation of the youth festival funds. He interviewed all the executive complainants, and he also went to the Funky Aid event at New Panjim, and he found details from the Funky Aid as well as the executive members. Amit Sadarekar submitted a detailed report to me, wherein it was found that Siddesh Ramdas Naik was guilty for misappropriation of Goa Institute's fund. Hence, it was unanimously decided by GPYC student cell to expel Mr. Siddesh Ramdas Naik from the GPYC.
He also produced a letter that was given by the event management company that claimed to have sponsored most of the items needed for the event and accused Naik for submitting fake bills for the same.
He had sponsored free of cost backdrop, effect lights, then LCD projectors and screens. But this Siddesh Naik has produced false bills of some Mirsi's fund. Mirsi's decorator has made false bills and 18,800 rupees withdraw from the institute. So from this letter and from the complaints of the executive member, it is proved that he has done a massive fraud over here. Also, Siddesh Naik has withdrawn 6,000 rupees for petrol.
He also accused Director of Students' Welfare of Goa University, Shyam Bhatt, for clearing the bills submitted by Naik without consulting the other members of the council.
Director of Students' Welfare have not taken into confidence this executive member before allowing him to withdraw the
Mr. Kautankar said that they have lodged a complaint against Naik at the Agasai police station.
They have taken it as NC. Even I don't understand why they have taken it as NC. They should register the case actually. The police should register the case. They have taken it as NC. We will demand from the Chief Minister that they should immediately register the case against him. And we also demand that university lodge a complaint against Siddesh Naik in the police. Because it is university's fund what they have, he has misappropriated.
He also condemned the statement made by Durgadas Kamath, convener of All Goa Students Forum, for making baseless allegations against him and threatened to file a defamation case against him.
I also condemn the statement made by Mr. Durgadas Kamath, who is the convener of the Goa Students Forum. He has said that Sunil Kautankar has done misappropriation of fund. Then if you want to learn how to do corruption, you can learn it from the student cell of Youth Congress. This is shocking. It is shame on Mr. Durgadas Kamath that being a student representative, he is making such baseless and false allegations without even knowing what is the situation. You would have at least said, Baba Sunil, you have done this. You would have at least called and asked whether you have done this. You would have at least mentioned, these are the allegations, this is the actual misappropriation that I have done. This is the action taken on me. Simply because of publicity, he is having pen and paper, he is writing press note and issuing press note. What is this?
We'll spill into a commercial break. Stay with us.